Friends, welcome to Khan Mahmud, job, training and consultancy. You can visit our website at khanmahmud.com. Have you ever heard such a negative question from your supervisor or the management in your job life? Like, what is your work? Do you have any work to do? What are you doing by sitting on that chair? Blah, 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 blah. And you were silent. Or you said, sir, I have many works. I do lot of things. I work full day, extra hour, etc., etc. Or your reporting boss or the management body asked you to give them what are your works and what is your department's functions. Or you are going to join in an organization and they have requested you to submit your work plan with that organization. So the solution of these issues are in this tutorial. Let's start the tutorial. And it's my request you to please subscribe my channel to inspire me. So we are going to departmental action plan, scope of work. See, this is the wing of your department. And wing is activities of your department. Here is the person in charge. That means who is responsible for which work. Let me explain. The wing is employee handbook. So the work preparing and updating employee handbook, registering handbook from the government authority and disclose the handbook to the employees, and these persons are the responsible for this wing. Standard operating procedure and quality system procedure, so monitoring and functioning according to SOP and QSP, and also update the following SOP and QSP. The SOP and QSPs are organization management chart, that means organogram, recruitment and selection, employment separation, employee exit interview process, and so many. Next thing is HR planning. So know and understand the strategic plan of the organization, assessing the current HR capacity, forecasting HR requirements, gap analysis, developing the strategies. Next thing is HR job rate and CTC. So if government gazette is not available, then you need to prepare a job rate, and you have to have the cost to company of each employee for the whole organization. And then the departmental budgeting. You have to have the departmental budget. So you need to prepare the budget and control the cash over the organogram or hierarchy or organization management chart. Each department wise job description and person specification. Recruitment and selection. So you need to have the manpower requisition from the respective department. Reviewing, justifying and approving the sources. Job advertisement preparing and posting, preliminary screening, employee database, updating the employee information in HR and payroll software. If it is not available, then update your information in the Excel database. And then employee personal file management, so receiving all the required documents from new colleagues, verifying the references, background, and the certificates if necessary, preparing hard file as per SOP guideline, and preparing electronic file as per SOP guideline. Employee induction, preparing joining circular and email it to the colleagues. Leave and attendance management. In case of leave, you may have some controlling system of the leave. This is very much applicable for the factories. Compensation management, so preparing monthly salary and benefits, and disburse the amounts. Training and development, so you need to assess the training needs, preparing annual training plan, developing training module, conducting the training, evaluating the training based on the business need and the gap. Probation and confirmation, so monitoring the probationary period, sharing the assessment form with the relevant department, take management decision for on-time confirmation or extension or termination. Performance management system, so raising annual midterm performance appraisal, share appraisal form with the relevant department, and preparing increment, promotion and other decision. Employee relation, always work for motivating employees by minimizing their grievances. Disciplinary action, preliminary inquiry, charge sheet delivery, consideration of explanation, inquiry committee formation, inquiry notice issuing, proper domestic inquiry, proper domestic inquiry report, inquiry report consideration by the authority, awarding of punishment and delivery of punishment letter. Employment separation, so monitoring employment separation notice from both sides, motivating them for minimizing the rate of turnover so that they can retain with the organization. Conducting employee exit interview and analyzes the outcomes. conducting the clearance process, preparing final settlements, expatriate service. It is for the foreign employees who will work here. So newspaper advertisement preparation, preparing board resolution, service contract, BOI, that means current is BIDA, PI or E-Visa, BIDA work permit, 18, security clearance, and their accommodation and logistic supports. You need to prepare the departmental action plan and also the to-do list of departmental employees. HRD reports, so you have to generate lots of reports for the management and for the departmental operation. You need to have the monthly HR activities presentation for the board. Departmental audit, it may be internal audit and maybe external audit. To run your department, you need to have lots of letters and applications like this. Also, you need to work with the lots of forms and formats. You need to circular various informations towards your colleagues. If you need any help regarding your job performance, or if you need any consultancy, please let me know. Thank you.